Making good flare fittings is really critical for long-lived systems without any leaks. John will be using both a battery-powered flare tool and a manual flaring tool here. For both methods, he'll use a good deburring tool and a digital torque wrench. When roughing in tubing, make sure you leave enough to make flares and a bit of slack in case something goes wrong. Move insulation out of the way.
Using a backing wrench to support the fitting here, I'm gonna loosen up these flare nuts. Now I'm going to make a really nice cut on the end of my copper.
Don't over tighten the cutters. After each full rotation, tighten the cutters about a quarter turn until you get a nice, clean, even cut. Deburr the cuts. John is using a cone-shaped tool here because this doesn't risk scratching the inside of the tubing. Keep the tubing facing downwards so any copper flakes fall out rather than back inside the tubing.
I remember to put the flaring nut on before I make the flare.
John's using a battery-powered tool to make these flares. Insert the tubing into the proper size die and use the stop to make sure it's at the right depth.
Insert it into the flaring tool, clicks into place, clamp it down, push the button.
Inspect the flare. Make sure it's shiny, even, and symmetrical, with no cracks, bumps, or flat spots. If there are any problems, cut it off and make a new one. Apply a very light coat of oil on the surface of the flare and the back of the flare to prevent it from binding. Also apply oil to the face of the cone. Don't get oil inside the tubing, and don't get oil on the threads themselves. This can interfere with torque settings. When tightening the fitting, you really need to use a torque wrench. Hand tightening just isn't reliable. Tightening too much and too little are equally bad. Both can result in leaks, and this can really hurt the system performance and longevity. Look up the torque specs in the manual for both the liquid and the suction lines. The proper torque range for this fitting is 25 to 30 foot-pounds, and John is setting the wrench in the middle of this range.
I want to use a backing wrench to support the fitting while I'm tightening. It's starting to beep, telling me I'm getting close. When it beeps continuously, it means that I've hit my 28 foot-pound target.
Use the same process for all flares. Record the torque settings used. It's an important piece of quality control. In part two of this video, John will demonstrate making flares with a manual tool. For good flares with a manual tool, use a tool that has a gauge or stop to position the tubing properly, an eccentric cone that rolls around the inside of the tubing to form the flare, and a clutch that will disengage the cone when the flare is complete.
For this installation itself, I used a battery-powered flaring tool, which I find to produce highly reliable flares. I'm also going to demonstrate the use of a manual flaring tool because that's what a lot of people prefer. So we start by making a nice clean square cut on the end of the copper using a sharp cutting tool, gradually tightening the blade. We deburr our copper. In the previous videos, I used a cone-shaped deburring tool. I like that because it doesn't risk scratching the inside of the copper. Now I'm going to use a blade-type deburring tool. And again, I want to make sure The end of the copper is pointing down so that any flakes don't fall into the tubing. I want to make sure I put my flaring nut on. Now I'm going to assemble my flaring tool, sliding the flaring block itself into the yoke, the tubing using the appropriate hole, and I use this stop here to make sure that it's at the correct depth. Slide the yoke into place, and it's gonna set on a little a divot to make sure it's properly centered. Make sure that's nice and tight. Now I'm gonna start turning the handle. I'm gonna click, and that tells me my flare is complete. There we go. Heard the click. Now I'm gonna back this all the way out. Loosen up my set screw. And there's my flare.